Hello my dear students, welcome back in EBS classes. I am Jaspreet Kaur, your EBS teacher. Dear student, in this video we are going to continue our chapter number 8, that is birds, friends of the sky. So in the previous video I have explained you about the birds. Okay, so we have understood about the birds. Now there are some features of the birds that we have discussed in the previous video. First was, we have discussed about their beaks. Okay, so there are the different species of the birds are there, and their eating habits are also different. So as their eating habits are different, so their beak are also different. The sizes of the beaks are different. Okay, the shape of the beaks are the different. So that is because their eating habits are different. Okay, next that we have discussed is about their feathers. Okay, about their feathers we have discussed. So as I have told you that there are the three types of the feathers. First is the down feather, and the function of the down feather is to keep the bird warm. Second type of the feather is the body feather, which gives the shape to the body of the bird. Third type of the feather is the flight feathers, which helps the bird to fly in the sky. Okay, and the flight feathers are present on their wings and the tails. So the wings of the birds, they help them to fly, and the tails help them to change the direction. Okay, so these two features we have discussed. Now we will discuss another one, that is the their different claws. Okay, their claws are also different according to the different species. Okay, and we will also learn about the different types of their wings. We will learn about their wings and these sounds. Okay, so you know that there are the different species of the birds, so their sounds are also different. So let's start.
So now the feet. Birds have 2 feet. They have 4 toes. Walking, hopping, picking things, catching and holding the food. So with the help of their 4 toes, they walk, they hop and they pick or catch the food. Different birds have different types of the feet. So here is the perching bird. Feet. Perching means the birds that sit on the branches of the trees. Okay, so birds like pigeons, sparrows, crow and parrots perches or sit on the branches. What is the meaning of the perching? Perching means to sit on or sit at a place. Okay, so mostly the birds, they sit on the branches. So they have a feet that help them to grip thin or thick branches easily. They have 4 toes, 3 faces towards the 4, and the means that 3 out of the 4 toes, the 3 they it faces forward, and the 4th faces the backward. Okay, so they can move easily toes independently, means each of the toes they can move independently. They are having the 4 toes now, so the 4 toes they can move independently one by one. Okay, so this is what is the perching. Perching means to sit on a place or on a bird. So that's why the pigeon and the sparrow, crows, they are having the perching feet. So next is the talons feet. So the birds like the eagle, hawk and the vultures, they eat and hunt other animals. So that's why their feet are the talons' feet. Okay, so they need a sharp hooked claws to catch their prey. So their claws are sharp and hooked, means the nails that is present on their claws that are hooked shaped, and they are, it is very sharp also, so which helps the to catch their prey. Okay, so these sharp hooked claws are called as the talons. Okay, these are the talons' feet. They birds like eagle, hawk, vultures, okay, it means the birds, those who hunt the other animals for their food, okay, or means the scavengers, we can say scavengers, their feet are the talon feet. Okay, so here is an example: eagle feet, hawk feet, vultures and the owl's feet. Now the next is the trowel's feet. Okay, what is it? Trowel's feet. Hence, rooster need to scratch ground to take out worms and seeds. Okay, so the hens or the rooster, okay, the cocks, they need to dig the ground. Okay, they need to dig a hole, okay, in the ground, sorry, on the ground, to take out the worms and the seeds. Okay, so that's why their claws are like a trowel's feet. Okay, like a trowel. So the trowel is a tool used to digging. What is the trowel? Trowel, it is a use, sorry, it is a tool which is used to dig a hole. So that's why their claws are called as a trowel's feet. Hands feet work like a trowel when they scratch the mud. Now the next is the climbing bird's feet. For example, like an woodpecker. Okay, so there are the different types of the woodpeckers. You can see woodpecker, yellow woodpecker, woodpecker. Okay, so the birds like woodpecker, they climbs the tree and they need to hold on to trees. So they have two sharp claws pointing in each the direction, okay, on their each foot. It helps them to hold the trees and branch, okay, and balance on the trees while they tap on the tree trunk. Okay, so you can see from the this image here that their claws are they are having the four toes, but each of the toe is directing to the four sides. Okay, and their nails are also very pointed. They are big and pointed. Even their claws are also big. Okay, which help them to balance on the trees and hold the branches, okay, or hold the tree trunk so that they can climb on the tree. Climb means trees mein chad sake. Okay, so that's why the, for example, I have told you the bird woodpecker are having the climbing birds, these are the climbing birds, and these are having the climbing feet. So next type of the feet is the webbed feet. Okay, which are look like a webs, okay, webs of the spider. So ducks, goose have feet with front toes joined by the skin. So you can see that their front toes, they are having the three toes. Okay, each of the birds are having the four toes, but the front three toes are joined together with the skin. So that's why their feet appears the flat. Such feet are called the webbed feet. Okay, so this type of the feet are called as the webbed feet. Webbed feet works like a paddles, okay, and help these in swimming. So that's why, as I've told you in the previous chapter also, that the duck waddles. So how the duck waddles? Because they are having the webbed feet. Okay, so the example you can see in the goose feet also. Okay, so their feet are also the webbed feet. The front three toes are joined together with the skin. Okay, so their front toes are joined with the skin, and the duck feet are also, their front three toes are joined with the skin. So this type of the feet are known as the webbed feet, which help them to swim. Next is the wading bird feet. So herons and the storks are wading birds who can walk in shallow waters. Okay, where the water is in shallow water is there, in that there, that place also the birds can walk. So they have long slender legs with spread out toes. These spread toes help them to walk in the water easily while catching the birds. Okay, so these are the example of the wading bird's feet are the stork, herons. Okay, and you can see their legs also, the stork legs and the heron's legs. The bird chirp means how the birds, they make the sounds. So birds do not have the teeth, they have a tongue which help them to make sounds. Okay, birds use specially sound to call their mates. We can identify birds from its call. Parrot is a special bird who can copy the human sounds and almost can speak like us. Okay, so there are the varieties of the parrots are also known. All the parrots cannot speak like a human. So the birds like the mynna, skylark, okay, cuckoo, nightingale, there are the different birds can make the different sounds. Okay, so the sounds of the mynna, cuckoo, skylark and the nightingale have the sweet sound, means very pleasant sounds they are having. So we can even identify whether the sound of the mynna or the skylark. Okay, the nightingale sound also and the cuckoo sound also. So all are having the different types of the sound, but their sounds are very pleasant. The next is the nest. Okay, so every species of the bird, they make a special kind of the their nest. Okay, homes of the birds is called as a nest. Birds make their nest to lay eggs and raise their young ones. A baby bird is called chick. It stays in the nest till they get old enough to fly, means until they learn to fly, they take rest in the nest only. So they have leave and fly off. When the birds, they learn to fly, so that time they leave their nest and they fly off. Birds use straws, fibers, wool, cotton threads, twigs, leaves and even the paper to build their nest. Okay, so by using all these things, the birds can build their nest with the help of their beak. So here you can see the nest of the other types of the bird. Mother bird, they lay eggs in the nest, then they take care of their eggs and keep them warm till they are ready to hatch. So here you can see the different types of the nest. Next is the migration. What is migration? Means to move from one place to the another place in search of the food and the shelter. So there are the some of the birds which migrate during the winter season. Okay, they leave their one place or their native place and they go to another place where the weather is warm or the summer weather is there, in search of the food and the shelters. So when the weather of the place becomes unsuitable for the birds, they fly away to other place. They come back when the weather changes again. This process is called as the migration. Okay, so when the birds leave their native place during the winter season, okay, and goes to the another place where the season is their favorable season, okay, so when the again the season of their native place becomes the favorable, so that time they comes back to their native place or to their home place. Okay, so this the birds who does this, okay, who changes their places during the weather change, so this process is known as the migration, and these type of the birds are known as the migratory birds. Okay, so here, and the birds are called the migratory birds. So you have to learn what is the migration and what are the migratory birds. So in winter, when it is very cold in Siberia, the Siberian cranes, okay, what is Siberian crane? It is the name of the bird. Siberian cranes fly to India, means the Siberian cranes, they fly from the Siberia to the India. They go back when it is warm in the Siberia. So the longest distance the migration is done by the Arctic tern. They fly from Arctic North Polar region to the South Polar region. So it is a quite long distance. Okay, so the example you can see of the migratory birds. Siberian crane, Arctic tern, and the European turtle dove. So Arctic tern covers the longest distance from North Polar region to the South.
So student, I hope you understood today's lecture. Now in the next video, we will start our new chapter. So till then, keep learning, stay safe and stay healthy.